The tax returns of former U.S. President Donald Trump will be made public Friday. The House Ways and Means Committee obtained the returns last month as part of an investigation into Trump's taxes. The panel released a report into its findings last week, which said the Internal Revenue Service broke its own rules by not auditing Trump during three of the 4 years of his presidency. But the release of the actual returns was delayed so that sensitive information could be redacted. Trump was the first presidential candidate in decades not to release his tax returns during either of his campaigns for president.
Russia imposes a ban on oil sales to countries and companies that comply with the price cap imposed in response to Moscow's offensive in Ukraine. The presidential decree will be in effect from February 1 until July 1. The price ceiling of $60 per barrel was agreed on by the European Union, G7, and Australia, and came to force in early December. Introduced alongside an EU embargo on seaborne deliveries of Russian crude, the cap aims to ensure Russia cannot bypass the embargo by selling its oil to third countries at higher prices. Russia said the cap will not affect its military campaign in Ukraine and expressed confidence it would find new buyers.
Taiwan announces an extension in mandatory military service, citing the threat from an increasingly hostile China. From 2024, compulsory military service for men will be extended from the current 4 months to 1 year. In addition, the Defense Ministry has pledged to transform the training for conscripts into a program featuring wartime scenario simulation. Taiwan President Tsai Ing-wen announced the defense push just 2 days after Beijing staged its largest maneuvers around the island in more than 4 months. China considers Taiwan a part of its territory to be taken one day by force if necessary. The island lives under the constant fear of a Chinese invasion.
The death toll continuing to climb following the monster storm that hit the United States over the Christmas weekend. More than 50 fatalities have been reported, most of them in road accidents. In New York's Buffalo area alone, at least 31 deaths have now been linked to what has been called the blizzard of the century. Buffalo was buried by more than 50 inches of snow. New York Governor Kathy Hochul says U.S. President Joe Biden has approved her request for a federal disaster emergency declaration, freeing up funds to help it recover from the disaster. The extreme weather over the weekend sent temperatures to below freezing in all mainland U.S. states. A thaw is now in sight, with the National Weather Service forecasting warmer temperatures by the coming weekend. Officials, however, warn the melting snow could result in minor flooding.
The number of fatalities from the Christmas weekend flooding in the Visayas and Mindanao climbs to 25. The Office of the Civil Defense says search and rescue operations continue for 26 others missing.
Search and rescue operations po natin para dito sa mga nawawala ay patuloy naman po, no? At nangunguna po dyan yung mga kawinin natin sa Philippine Coast Guard, dahil karamihan nga po ito yung mga isla at nawala po sila sa ating coastal areas.
According to the OCD, floodwaters in at least 15 areas have not receded. In Misamis Occidental, where a state of calamity has been declared, at least one resident says they have not received any help from the local government.
As of the moment po, wala po kaming kuryente at tubig at wala pa rin pong tigil yung ulan since Saturday po. Nakaka-receive naman kami ng relief through our friends. Pero from local government, wala po kami na-receive.
In other news, the Philippines is considering the purchase of a dozen multi-role fighter aircraft from Sweden. This was discussed in a December 21st meeting of Acting Defense Chief Jose Faustino Jr. and Stockholm's Ambassador to Manila, Annika Thunborg. The Swedish defense and aerospace company, Saab AB, is offering its Gripen aircraft to the Philippine Air Force. The Philippine Defense Department is also considering the acquisition of the F-16 Fighting Falcon of the U.S. company, Lockheed Martin. Philippine defense officials say the multi-role fighters will be used to patrol the country's airspace. The Philippines previously sought to acquire heavy-lift helicopters from Russia, but this was scrapped by the Duterte administration amid fears of possible U.S. sanctions due to Moscow's invasion of Ukraine.